This is the only video you'll ever need to master support and resistance. I'm going to show you the power of support and resistance to make money in the market and predict the future of the market. Right here, we have no information of what's going to happen at every single level, except the fact that we know 30K is going to be extremely significant. And I'll go as far as to say 40K is going to be equally significant. Now watch what happens to price. As it comes up and breaks this level, it comes back down, tests it, bounce right off. This shows demand. This shows that price hits this level, it goes back up. But it's only happened once. Let's wait for a bit more information. Similarly, you see the price has just gone up, hit this 40K level, bounce back down, and we've now got more data that people want to buy at 30K. Going forward, anytime the price comes down to 30K, we're going to buy. Anytime the price goes up to 40K, we're going to sell. Price went up to 40K. Opportunity to sell. You would have made money if you sold there. Price has come back down to 30K. You would have made money if you bought there. Again, another opportunity to buy, and price goes back up again. Now, price has broken and gone past this level. The next place you want to pay attention to will be 50K here, which we've broken past, but watch. This right here is a trap. Price has deviated, and we're going to study these in today's lesson. Resistance, price comes back to support. Next, just arbitrarily take this 60K level and notice again, price resists off of it, comes back down, bounces here, resists again. I'm going to fast forward a bit in time now. Notice, after all this time, so much time has gone past, but the price comes back down, and again, test this 30K level as support. It's somewhere you could have bought. 40K level, again, a perfect opportunity to sell. And again, perfect sell, perfect buy. Perfect buy, here, the sell fails, price goes up, hits resistance again at 50K. Do you see the power of these levels? Just keep watching. Keep watching how the price continually interacts with every single one of these levels. If you identified and traded solely off of these four levels through the entire period of the bull market, you would have been successful. And now I'm going to show you how to figure out these levels for yourself and trade in the market. Now, please take a moment to read these disclaimers. Let's recap support and resistance. What are these levels? Well, support is an area where there is demand or buying interest for an asset. It means price hits that level, people want to buy, therefore price goes up after it comes to that level. Next, we have resistance, which is the opposite. This is where there is supply or selling interest. This is where people are looking to offload their bags. So when price hits this level, it tends to get pushed back down. So in general, these are key areas on the chart where we expect a lot of buying and selling to happen. So what are they? Key levels on the chart where we expect buying or selling to happen. Let's circle back to the example we showed at the start of this video. Here you can see a support level where we expect buying to happen. Every single time price has come to this level, to this area, buying has occurred. This is a very solid support. You can see over here, a resistance, because every single time price hit this level, selling occurred. So how do we know buying or selling occurred? Because look, price hits this level, it goes up. Price hits this level, it goes up. Price hits this level, it comes back down. Now follow along with me, because you'll notice here, the price broke this level. These are not guaranteed levels. They are guidelines that help inform our trading decisions. Now in context, I'm going to show you every single thing that can happen at a support or resistance level. Number one, the level holds. Take a look at all these examples where the level has held. Over here, the level held. Why? Because price came down to this level and then pushed back up afterwards. Here, held. Held again at every single one of these levels. Here, the price holds. So at a support, price holds when it hits this level and then bounces back up. At a resistance, the price holds when it hits this level, comes back down. Hits this level, comes back down. Next thing that could happen at these levels is that the price breaks the level. Let's take a look at examples where the price has broken the level. Here, resistance holds, and then it breaks. Price absolutely smashes through it. Again, here's an example of support breaking. Price comes below, goes a little bit back up, and then smashes through it. Here, the support broke again. Price went through. Resistance here, broke. These are examples of the level breaking. Now, there's one more important scenario that we need to know about, and those are traps. Sometimes the price, like in this instance here, will go just above and make you think it's about to break it and then smash back down under. Take a look at this over here at the 60K resistance. Price goes up, then smashes back down. It makes it look like it's about to break, but then comes straight back down. This here is a perfect example. Notice price goes up with two weak candles from the bull army and then smashes back down and breaks. So at these levels, the price can hold. Price can break, or it can set up a trap and then immediately fall back under. I want you to think back to our analogy about the bull and bear armies. Now, the candles represent the soldiers. The wicks represent fallen soldiers, failed attempts to get into enemy territory. Now, support and resistance levels represent walls. Resistance is a wall from the bear army. Support is a wall from the bull army. Using this analogy, it can become very clear intuitively what is happening on the charts and how strong these walls are. Using this army analogy, we can paint a really good picture of what is happening, and it can make data analysis so simple. Now that we've got the basics down, we're going to start evolving our understanding of support and resistance. So support and resistance are interchangeable. If you take a look at these examples over here, you can see that the 40k level at this point was acting as a consistent resistance. But then after it broke and the price came back down, it became a support. Taking the army analogy, this is like the wall being captured by the opposite army. Sometimes the wall gets destroyed so bad that the opposite army can't use it. In those cases, it does not flip, but if it breaks cleanly, comes back down, retests, and the bears or bulls manage to capture it, it will now act in favor of the opposite army. Taking a look at another example, you can see over here, the 60k level was consistently a support, and then it broke, price came back up, tested it, resistance. Broke, price came back up again, take a look here, tested it, it was a resistance. So support and resistance are interchangeable. When a support breaks, it can flip into a resistance. When a resistance breaks, it can flip into a support. The next concept that's extremely important, and a lot of beginners get caught out by this, it's not an exact line, it's actually just a general area. We can use some advanced strategies like laddering to make sure we take advantage of this. You'll learn about that later in the course, but for now, take a look. It's not always hitting the exact point. Each of these lines are better represented by areas. The line is just a guideline, so it doesn't matter if you put 40,000, 39,50, 40,50, like it's really not important the exact level you use. You just need to know that in this general area, this sort of price action is going to happen. And you can see when you treat them as areas, it captures a lot more of the movement and you're prepared for a lot more to happen. And now the final rule, which is really important, is never use this in isolation to buy and sell. You can't just buy because it's a support or just sell because it's a resistance. You need a lot of other factors. You need to take into account the macro trend. You need to use proper risk management. You need to have a tested system. All of these things you'll learn how to use and put them together, but support and resistance can be a huge part of your trading system, but they do need to be a part of a system and not used in isolation. Another point that's actually extremely important is to pay attention to key psychological levels. Notice at the start of the video, every level we placed was a big round number. Now, there are a few different types of levels that will be considered key psychological levels. The first one are nice round numbers. People often like to set themselves targets which feel good. For example, 30,000 Bitcoin, 40,000 Bitcoin, 50,000 Bitcoin, 60,000 Bitcoin. Some of these will be more significant than others. For example, 50,000 is halfway through to 100, so it's going to be a big milestone. Obviously, 100 is going to be so significant because so many people will have bought Bitcoin and said, I want to sell it at 100K. Now, this can change depending on the asset. For example, if we bring up the Ethereum chart right here, $4,000 over here, significant level, resistance, support. You can see it there, $3,000, exactly the same thing. Notice, support, deviation, back above. $2,000, exactly the same thing again, clean resistance, support, deviation, but still somewhat of a support. These round numbers work on every single asset. Now there is one other level which is extremely important, not just the round numbers, but specific milestones. Milestones are previous all-time highs. Going back to Bitcoin right now, $68,000 over here is going to be extremely significant. Why? Because this was the highest point the price got to. So breaking that again is all-time highs. Therefore, it's very significant. Also, on this chart, psychologically, $30,000 is going to be really important because it's the most recent support that was held before the price changed its trend. So $30,000 down here is really important because look, it hasn't broken. It's held so many times. So people get emotionally attached to that level. Not only that, but remember, every time this level holds, it means more and more people bought at this level. So if it does end up breaking, it's going to be a huge victory for the Bear Army. Now we're going to go through a support and resistance analysis process. I'm going to get into the specific details and break down how I think about them. First point of data analysis, sample size. We need to know how many data points we have. The more data points we have, the more established the level becomes. If you take a look here, you can see that this level has held multiple times. At every single data point, the support has shown strength. However, the number alone is not enough because if you take a look over here, we've got three separate data points. Test, bounce, test, bounce, test, bounce. Two of these are bullish. One of these actually make the argument weaker, and I'll show you how to figure that out. You figure that out by analyzing the quality of the data points. The first quality point I want you to look out for is if they show strength. Do these levels show strength? And strong or weak are always relative. So if we take a look at this first test here, huge wick up. The army managed to absolutely decimate a whole bunch of bearish soldiers and get back up. Great. Second test, same thing happened. Both of these look really nice over here. Let's zoom in a bit. Okay, now, however, take a look at the second example here. Price came down, but then it barely pushed back up. Whereas previously, it got up to here. This time, it only got up to here. So this test over here shows that the bulls have actually gotten a bit weaker. After testing this level, they couldn't push the price back up as high. Therefore, this data point makes me think, ooh, this wall's getting a bit weaker. The bulls aren't able to push back off after the bears try and break the wall. So this argument makes me think it gets a bit weaker. And then here, we have a huge bounce off of it. So makes the argument stronger again. Let's take a look at our other data points. Here, huge bounce. Here, huge bounce. So all of these make me think that this level still remains extremely strong. Now let me show you an example of a level with lots of data points that's actually pretty weak. Over here, the 60K level. Here, the 60K level, first data point. Price went up and down, didn't really touch the level cleanly. It actually got a close and then came down slowly afterwards. Here again, we had another deviation. The level wasn't really expected. We had a bit of a trap over here. Price went above, came back down. This does not look like a really strong wall to me because the army, every time it tries to break through it, it does. And that's why after those two tests, and maybe here we barely got up to it, price went up here, tested it as a support. Even when testing it as a support, we had a break like this, went back above and came back down. This level is not very high quality. There's lots of choppiness, people going back and forth between the wall. We've still seen some signs that it's relevant, but if you compare it to this 30K level over here that looks extremely strong, extremely clean, you can see huge differences between them. Cleaning up the chart a little bit, let's take a look at the 40K level. This one, clean data point there, another clean one, a break, price comes back down, lots of clean data points here, a slight deviation there, and again, a very clean data point there. This sort of price action, again, indicates a more significant, a stronger level relative to the 60K, which just doesn't get respected as much. So you need to take into account all this information to get an idea of how strong these levels are. So what are the factors matter for the quality of data points? Another one is recency. I've seen even advanced traders ignore this fundamental principle. The more recent price data is, the more accurate a representation of the current market it gives you. Because if something happened a year ago, it's less likely to represent the current participants of the market than something that happened 1 month ago. And how do we use this in practice? It means when we're determining the strength of a level, I'm going to put more emphasis on and give more value to the stuff that happens more recently. If something happened back here, during this bit of price action, it's going to be less important than something that happened over here during this bit of price action. Something that advanced and beginner traders alike avoid. Is the macro trend bullish or bearish? If the trend is bullish, then the bulls are going to be stronger than the bears. Resistance is more likely to break. Support is more likely to hold. If the bears are winning, then resistance is more likely to hold and support is more likely to break. Take a look at this example over here. Now, we haven't in this course yet gone in detail into trend analysis. That's to come, in fact, in next week's lesson. But you can take a look over here and notice that support is generally stronger than resistance. Notice this 30K level, it just does not break. Notice when we get above and back onto this 40K level, it broke once here, and then as soon as the price got back above, it held as a support. Notice that our resistances, this 50K level, none of these data points are clean. We smash above it here. When we get above, there's another track there as the price tries to go above. Without many attempts, we get back above it again. The 60K level, continually disrespected from a resistance perspective. This is because we are in a bullish trend here. The supports are more likely to hold, the resistances are more likely to break. In a bear trend, it is the opposite. Now, figuring out the trend is one of the greatest challenges any trader is going to be faced with, but I'm going to give you all the tools to figure it out. First, in next week's lesson, we're going to go over trend analysis. You've got the candlestick wall already. You can use that to get an idea of the trend. I'm going to show you a whole bunch more techniques, from Fibonacci tools to market structure analysis to moving averages. All of these will come together to give you a great idea of the trend. Then we're going to go beyond the charts. I'm going to show you how to do fundamental analysis on assets to get an idea of what the asset is and whether it's bullish or not. Then I'm going to show you how to keep a pulse on the market, because you need to know macro, what macro sentiment is like, because when we look at the charts, we're trying to figure out human psychology. So we cannot ignore the actual news and media and developments that are going on in the market. To help you with this, not only am I going to show you how to analyze it, but for those of you who don't know, as well as this free course, I publish not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, but six free newsletters every single week to keep you up to date with the crypto market. No catch, just like this course. You have access to it for free, and it will keep your pulse on the market sentiment and everything that's going on there. One of your assignments today is actually going to be to subscribe and start keeping a pulse on the market and what is going on in it. And it doesn't even stop there. There's going to be so many more tools you can learn in this course. You don't need to use every single one, but you need a basic understanding of all of them, and then just pick the ones you like the most and hyper-focus on those to build a profitable system and start making money in the crypto market. Now let's go over a trade example using primarily support and resistance. So prices come back down. Let me tell you the story of everything that's going on here. And this is a trade I actually took myself. So we have a support over here at the 30K level. Price is coming down. If you look at the candlestick wall, it looks quite bearish because most of these candles are in favor of the bears. The bulls are continually getting weaker and the price is going down. That's why it's actually pretty risky to try buy this support over here, because remember the context, the bears are winning, so supports are less likely to hold right now. Next, I'm going to draw my resistance over here at the 40K level. This is a big resistance. This is a wall set up by the bears. And right now we are under the assumption that support is less likely to hold than resistance. And resistance is more likely to hold because the recent trend has been continually going down. And we've got our other resistance level up here at 50K. So let's take a look at what happens. Price test this support. If you are very risky, or you have a strong reason outside of just the charts to think that this level is going to hold, then yeah, you could go for a trade here. Personally, I'd avoid that one specifically. Now, price comes up. One potential trade is a short over here. But I also want to avoid the short because I know the macro trend for the longest time has been going up. Specifically, I'm looking for the perfect long play. So now price has gone up and got above this level. So we've seen resistance break and we see the bulls starting to win the battle. So something I'd love to do is buy if the price comes back down to this level, because it will have flipped. So if price comes here, I will be looking to buy, but we also need a stop loss. You'll learn how to play stop losses later in this course. So let's draw out our position. A stop loss is where I lose the trade. The price comes down to here, I'll take my loss and sell, because if you remember from my introductory videos, controlling downside is extremely important. Then for my upside target, I'm going to target the next wall, the next resistance. So here, I might lose 7% or I might make 24.6%. And why do I think the support is going to hold? Well, it was a resistance over here and over here. It broke out over here. Remember, 40K is a key psychological level. We care about these psychological levels. So price comes back down, I'm going to buy over here. Let's continue playing this out. Price goes up, hits a resistance, comes back down, and there's our test. There's our test. The price failed to break there, came back down. The trend in the short term looks bullish right now. Macro, I like taking longs on this asset. This is the trigger for our trade. We've entered the position over here and we're looking to sell back at 50K, and price goes back up. That is a real trade example using almost entirely just support and resistance. The only thing here, which I actually used, was a bit of market structure analysis to position my stop loss, which you will learn all about in the next video. Don't forget forget to click on the link in the description below to get access to the full episode summary, detailed assignments to help you better understand the lessons, and extra reading material. I'll see you next time for Trend Analysis.